صلوا على محمد وآل محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين أبي القاسم محمد وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
First, inshallah, عظم الله أجوركم جميعا on this night that we commemorate every year. And tonight, your heart should be a little softer, inshallah. And you should be trying to extend yourself to a point where you can expand yourself to a different level, inshallah. And really, these nights hold a special place in everyone's heart. It's your connection with Allah. But what means do you take to get there? What road, what path? You have to pick a path. And that person that you follow better know Allah. So these are some of the reasons that why we hold these nights. And these nights are so important in terms of your own identity and how you identify with a personality. So, Imam Ali alayhi salam is a figure in history like no other. Check, look back, do your research, I urge you. Try to find someone of this personality. Now, as we are growing up, we develop an attitude. An attitude is a set of beliefs and ideas. And on this level, it's usually taken in from the outside, internalized by usually the child, then it's put forth to the outside. So usually our personalities are taken in from the outside first. Then as we grow, we kind of reformat your personality, reformat it, then you kind of change it and mold it to yourself because you have more control over yourself. So, on this level, there's a lot of stuff that happens in between. The insecurities that come from the outside world to the inside. And this is what I really want to touch on tonight. The securities and insecurities that are in this world now. And where is Imam Ali in terms of security? When Thalib al-Yamani comes to him, he says, هَلْ رَأَيْتَ رَبَّكَ يَا أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. He says to him, have you seen your Lord? He says to him, أَعْبُدُ مَا لَا أَرَىٰ. Do you think I would actually pray or worship someone I don't see? He says, وَكَيْفَ تَرَاهُ. How do you see him? He says, لَا تَرَاهُ الْعُيُونَ بِمُشَاهَدَةِ الْعِيَانِ. He says, the naked eye does not see him. وَلَكِنْ تُدْرِكُهُ الْقُلُوبِ بِحَقَائِقِ الْإِيمَانِ. But surely, the heart is certain of his existence. It sees him, it's clear. This is a sense of security. This is security. Can any car, house, person, anyone give you that kind of security? Ask you, try. Try to replace that in your heart. I swear to you, today I got a call from someone. 10-day vacation. Where? In Italy. The person's like, I'm dying to come back home. The person said, it's empty. It's empty. There's nothing here. So what gives security to the heart? Is it a trip to Italy? Is it falling in love with someone? What is it? This is what we have to seek. And for the parents tonight, please listen. Because there's so many things on your doorsteps that are happening to our children today. I'm going to give you some numbers that are crazy. Especially with women. Our girls, how they're being objectified. They're subjected to certain things. It's mind-blowing. Once you do the research, it's really amazing. Just to give you a number, a quick number. $235.6 billion are being spent on advertising. To what? What do you think they're being advertised? What do you think is being advertised? No, we put on a Ramadan commercial. We raised over $30,000. Look at what you're fighting. $235 billion a year. This is to what? Mold the minds of our children here. And especially with girls. An attitude, let me give you an attitude really quickly. I don't have much time, but here's an attitude. An attitude is an evaluation for or against a person, object, or idea. This is your attitude. Now, what dictates an attitude? What are the social agents that work on an attitude, work on our kids? What are they? This is what creates the insecurity versus security. Now imagine, always through this whole lecture, Imam Ali's security versus our own security today. So now, here's the five things that create an attitude for our children as they're growing up. Number one, parents. They have the most influence. But now media is changing that, by the way. Religion, schools, peers, and the media. These are the five things that dictate an attitude. Now, let's look into the media really quickly. I'm going to give you some numbers here. And I'm telling you, when I'm doing this research, I have a little girl that's 8 years old. It's scary. It scares me. It may not be you. It may not be you. It may be your friend. It may be your cousin. I have family, extended family, in jail for 4 years. Personally. So now, it can reach anyone. Let me give you some numbers of what's happening around us now. 53% of girls age 13 years of age are unhappy with their bodies. 53% of 13-year-old girls are unhappy with their bodies. Now look what happens by the age of 17. That number jumps to 78%. 8 out of 10 girls are unhappy with their figure. Where's this coming from? I told you $235 billion is being pumped into this a year. Now, let's go further. Women spend on cosmetics and beauty cosmetics and the salons on an average of $12,000 to $15,000 a year. Again, we're going to look into this. Where's our security coming from? Is it external or is it internal? Imam Ali alayhi salam said what? لَا تَرَاهُ الْعُيُونَ بِمُشَاهَدَةِ الْعِيَانِ وَلَكِنْ تُدْرِكُهُ الْقُلُوبِ بِحَقَائِقِ الْإِيمَانِ. His security is internal. It's not external. When we beautify ourselves to the outside world, where's our security at? You tell me I look good, that's my security. You tell me I can put up 315 pounds on the bench, that's my security. The more clothes I take off, that's my security. I'm getting attention. Bottom line. Now, further. 65% of younger girls, 65% of girls in the US have eating disorders. Body image. Again, it's all on our doorsteps. This is mostly based towards women because women have a harder time with this. But men also are now, you see them taking them out the garbage, they're in a tank top. Flexing. In the mirror. Men have become like women in terms of how much they love themselves. I'm not saying you shouldn't love yourself. You should love yourself, obviously, but for the right reasons. So now, depression, the rates of depression have jumped from the year 2000 to 2010, they've doubled the rates of depression. In the United States, the average procedure, cosmetic procedure, in terms of a facelift, costs around $12,000. That's enough to pay for 4 years of a community college. If these things aren't scary, I don't know what is. Seriously, really think about this, what I'm saying right now. Our children are gonna have to face this. This is what's out there. Inside the home may be safe and secure. As soon as they go out to school, believe me, they're comparing themselves like no other. They want to fit in on every single level. It's scary. So now, here, one of the guys, I just share a little story with you and I'll conclude and jump to the other side. One of the guys comes up to me after a lecture. He comes up and he says to me, he says, "You know, I'm not being tried. I feel like I've reached such a great standard." I go, "Really?" I said, "I see a lot of problems already." He says, "What do you mean?" I said, "I see a lot of problems." I go, "Can I be blunt with you?" He's like, "Sure." I go, "Are you sure? Can you handle criticism?" He's like, "Yes, please." I go, "Okay, no problem." I go, "Why is your shirt so tight that I can see the linings of your stomach through your shirt? All I see is insecurity within you." He looks at me, he's like, "What do you mean?" I go, "I'll paint it really simply for you." I go, "When someone is trying to sell something, let's say a bunch of diamonds, what do? They put them in the best displays. They shine the most expensive lights on them so they glimmer. What are they trying to do?" I said, "Aren't they trying to attract your attention? That's what they're doing." I go, "Why are you doing the same thing? Why do you need attention?" And he just sat back and he's thinking. I go, "Why do you need someone to tell you that you look good? Why don't you cover up and know that you look good?" And he was just baffled. He looked at me and he said, "No one's ever told me this before." He said, "I need to work on myself, don't I?" I go, "Yeah, you have a lot of work to work on." But understand, when our security is external, it's the most damaging thing to our self-esteem. Especially when you put up pictures on Facebook or Instagram or Snapchat. I can keep going. This is the danger. I know some of you are laughing. But when you do that, and you're asking the world to tell me, "Look, I look okay and I look good," understand there's an internal problem and it's a lot deeper than what you think. Understand. And when it hurts me more is when I see older women doing that. I can go into some psychological aspects, but I don't have time, of where this stuff stems from. The less you put on, the more attention you will get, bottom line. So that's what's happening to us. I take more off, I put myself in certain poses so I can track more attention, so people can just what? Comment or tell me what? They like me. Do they really like you? Again, we have to check ourselves. Please, on this night, check yourself. Look into yourself. See, where is this coming from? Now, let me just give you some understanding. Imam Ali alayhi salam, as he wakes up for the night, he goes to sleep. Imagine you know tomorrow you're going to die. Imagine that. Jibra'il tonight came down and he said, "Tomorrow you are going to die." What would happen to us? Any one of us. What would happen to you? Can you sleep throughout the night? Can you? I tell you, not many of us can. Why? I looked into this. I watched a documentary on death row. People who are going to be executed. The last 24 hours, what happens to them? The psychological weight is incredible. Imagine Imam Ali, and imagine the person who's on death row. They say, when they take out that person to go towards the electric chair, it feels, it's 10 feet. He said, it feels like we're walking a mile. Why? Because it's the last moments of your life. Everything slows down within the brain. Everything. You're taking everything in. All the information, you're taking it in. Now imagine Imam Ali alayhi salam. He's willingly, his test is what? I know I'm going to die, but I have to go towards my death. How many of us would be able to do that? Now, the reason I'm saying this is look at the heart. Where's the heart? Are you secure? Where is the heart? Would you be thinking in this time about Facebook? Would you be thinking about posting the next picture? Which vacation? Which car I'm gonna buy? I guarantee you, you will not. That's the last thing you'll be thinking about. So on this level, Imam Ali alayhi salam walks willingly towards his trial. As they take the prisoner in and they open the door, the first thing the guy says, he says the first thing they look at is the chair. Subhanallah. Imagine what Imam Ali alayhi salam looked at as his final place. Not a lecture chair, but what? A prayer mat. Subhanallah. Imagine, seriously, imagine this is you. What kind of dignity Allah has given you? You are born in the Kaaba. You are gonna die on Laylatul Qadr. And you're gonna die in sujood. Imagine that. Where's your heart? Imagine, think of Imam Ali's heart. The security that's within that heart. When in the Quran it says, وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَحُولُ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَقَلْبِهِ. My God. Subhanallah. When Allah intervenes between a man and his heart. This is Imam Ali. Then he goes willingly into sujood. He comes back up and he's struck. What resonates to me is the level of security in this person's heart. The level of iman in his heart. Then he says, it's amazing. How many of us, if we are struck, we would say, Fustu wa Rabbul Kaaba. Seriously, think about that. I have succeeded by the Lord of the Kaaba. How many of us would have that kind of security? That we are inching closer to our death and we would say this. How many of us would do that? This is our guide. This is what you need to have in your heart. This is what makes us Muslims. The epitome of belief, Imam Ali alayhi salam. Sallu ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.